Come here. We're going to Phoenix.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Let's do it.
Alright, what's your one goal for the week?
Alright, Avery. I want to find the lost tomb of a pharaoh.
Wow, that's a famous.
I'm gonna eat a cactus.
I'm trying to go to the beach and swim in the waves.
I just want to touch a cactus, maybe. Don't be me. If you wanna go, you can leave and leave my heart alone. Waking up to nothing when you're super far from home, and I watch you fall asleep at night and lay there on my own. Got me begging for affection, all you do is roll your eyes. Broken down. Hey, where are we going?
I have no idea.
Are you serious?
I'm just trying to lay down on this thing and ride around for a while.
I don't think you can do that.
I think I can if I do it.
Okay. Where are we at?
The warmth and sunshine.
Where
are
we at?
Phoenix, Arizona.
Heck yeah. You should know, do you know, know what
you want?
We made it to Phoenix, boy.
Made it.
So the flight was great, except I had to sit next to the toilet the whole time. And when people take a dump, it smelled like crap. Go figure. Don't be me. If you're here for good, I'm gonna need a little more from you. Waking up to nothing when you're super far from home, and I watch you fall asleep at night and lay there on my own. Got me begging for affection, all you do is roll your eyes. Broken down, I've had enough. If this is love, I don't want it. All my friends keep saying that I'm. Guys, we found Aaron.
We did it.
Hey, Azra, I'm right here.
And we're at In-N-Out. It's gonna be so awesome.
I will get the boomerang in the vlog. Come on.
Yeah. In the vlog?
In the vlog. What are you doing?
What am I doing?
This is first time.
Here we go.
So you picked my nose. My favorite thing about Arizona is the people that I do my life with. But my second favorite thing about Arizona.
I didn't ask about that.
I'm telling you. Wow. Thank you so much for bringing me here today. My favorite thing about Arizona is now Mike and Mickey. Because he's here in Arizona.
So. But wouldn't that count as the first category?
I mean, no, but you're not like my Arizona people. My social security number is, I'm a digital design major with emphasis on web design. Artsy fartsy, mostly fartsy.
So if you need a job, right?
I do need a job. Big job girl. Currently I have 3 jobs.
Alright, so what if you were gonna be an animal, what would you be?
A narwhal.
A narwhal?
Alright. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe.
'Pearson. I'm from Los Angeles, Torrance specifically. LA's the worst, Phoenix the best.
If you were an animal, what would you be?
A dolphin, because they just get to swim all the time. Like, what a life, you know? All this racket, never should have called, so just go and tell your friends about it. I said some things I wish I hadn't. I wish that we could talk about it. Don't think I can live without you banging on your door, screaming, you're the only way I'll have it. When I find you, I hope you change your mind. Less than I do, but maybe I'll change this time. Are you sitting out here listening to a magpie squawk and make a bunch of stupid noises?
What is that?
I'm about ready to chuck a rock at it. The dumb bird up there in the
trees. Which rock would you choose?
If I had to choose a rock, I'd want one that I could throw hard.
So this one.
One that has enough power. That's not a rock.
Oh. So which one would you pick?
I'd probably choose this rock right here.
It's a nice rock.
It is a nice rock. If I could really wind it up, you know what I'm saying?
How would you throw it if you threw it?
So here we are, your interviewee, Mike McGee, here on the CCB Residence Spring Break Trip 2019. Stay woke. We have a surprise today. We're at the Surprise Campus. It's a surprise. We are interviewing Mackenzie.
A surprise guest.
Here we are. Yeah. Have you? Yeah. She's Snapchat famous, so very, very.
Tell us your Snapchat.
It's Kenzie, K-E-N-Z-I-E, Christine, K-R-I-S-T-I-N-E-E. Subscribe to me. I post a lot of interesting content. Had to pull a lot of strings to make this happen today, so I'm honored to be with you guys.
Yes. If you could be one dinosaur on my shirt, what would you be?
Yeah, the Velociraptor Rex.
The Velociraptor Rex, I think there's right here. Trust me, I am a...
One of the people that study dinosaurs? I'm one of the...
Dinosauriologists?
A dinosauriologist.
Alright, go ahead.
It's your spokesperson, Micah McGee, at the Surprise Campus of the Surprise at CCV. We have a second surprise for you today. Our second guest, introduce yourself, sir.
Pow, 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 pow!
Yeah, I'm Renault, guys.
Feel it, I'm educated and sexy.
For the Lord.
Educated and sexy. All right, sweet. So I'm going to ask you a few questions. If you could be one dinosaur on my shirt, which one would you be?
All of them.
Dude, so that would be like a Renaultosaurus Rex.
Yeah.
Oh!
I just love it here. It's lit.
You do love it here? It's nice
lit.
And warm, too.
It's nice
that.
And warm. I'm trying to get this body right so I can take off my shirt. For the Lord.
It looks like you already ripped it on accident.
No, it's hard came. Target.
Oh, okay. If you could be one donut, what would you be?
A glazed donut.
Just like a Krispy Kreme hot.
Yeah, a classic. Rare. Oh, God, I know.
I got a question. Will you come to our hot tub party tonight at 9:30?
I'm coming to the party tonight at 9:30.
Yeah, yeah, I'll be there.
Send me the address. All send right, me the Addy.
Hey.
Now I feel like it's all over. So I've been trapped inside my head for so long. I'm sorry, I should've called when I was sober. Some days I get scared to be alone.
Alright, so we left our hotel and we took an Uber to Scottsdale, Arizona, and we wanted to ride on these scooters.
We got your Scoot Gang.
Scooter Gang. And we drove all the way to In-N-Out on the scooters.
Woo!
It was like 6 miles and we got there and we weren't able to park the scooters there. So we had to drive somewhere else, but then we realized that an Uber from here to our hotel is over $90. We've already spent $50, and then we spent money on these scooters. So. Right now it's $90. We're trying to get back and not spend that much money. So, yep. How do y'all feel about
see
that?
See this. Come pick us up.
Yeah, somebody come pick us up, please. We really need some
Light
help.
Buy food.
But I'm better off when I stay quiet.
We made it back. It was a long day with stories to come. And without giving anything away, boys, how was tonight, David? How do you feel?
What term did you use? Unforgettable.
Unforgettable. Here we go. Boys, how do you feel about tonight?
I almost died on a scooter.
Spoiler alert,
maybe if you heard that. Tomorrow is going to be a good day of some fun tales. It's our last day tomorrow. I definitely just got mad naked. Do it for the vlog. Matt was just naked in that. But tomorrow's our last day. We're going to be in the classroom, yay. But tomorrow we'll have some story time. Good night, vlog.
Alright. So, last night we were hinting at some interesting things that happened. And what happened was this, if you all can see it. I don't know if they can see it or not.
I probably can.
But, I died last night.
Yes, so you did.
It happened, but I fell off my scooter and went to heaven for a little bit. So here we are.
So here's what happened. The pack got dispersed. Dispersia, right?
There we go.
And so Avery and David had to stay back because they wanted the In-N-Out, of course. But the problem was me and Kenyon and Matt's scooters were out of range.
How does it feel to be out of range, Kenny?
It felt pretty bad last night.
Felt pretty bad. So we had a track way far away. And on our track, and many scooters later, me and Matt and Kenyon are just doing a little joyride, right? Just enjoying the times. Spring break, 2019, stay woke. And Matt's living on the edge, bro. How did it feel to live on the edge, Matt?
It felt amazing to live on the edge.
He was living on the edge, swerving. He was like the five D's of dodgeball. But when it came to duck, he wiped out hard. We were going about 15 to 20 miles an hour. And Matt just ate it. And I was in front of him. Kenyon was behind him. Kenyon had to pull some evasive maneuvers not to run over his fat head. And I turn around and I see Matt's on the ground because I heard the thud. And Kenyon's on the ground. And I'm like, oh my gosh, they just ran over each other. But the thing that happened is Matt fell off the ledge. And Kenyon fell on the ground laughing. So that made the trip. Do you want to introduce the second part?
No, we'll leave it there.
All right, we'll leave it there. Bring it right back. I just let the time out pass. We don't gotta take it too fast. Bring it right back. We made it to the airport. Avery, how's it feel to be in the airport?
Great.
Great. Where's Huffman? Huffman's way back there. Buying shoes, probably. There he is, looking for it. David, it's the end of our trip. How was it? Cap it off in two sentences.
Two sentences? I don't have two sentences. Words can't express how great this trip has been.
Words can't express. Well, we had some unforgettable memories, and hopefully some we can go back to. Matt, how are you feeling?
Yeah, I'm feeling great, bro.
He's feeling great, bro.
This trip was unforgettable, I'll tell you that.
Unforgettable. Amen. Well, we made it. We're going to get some food. Log out.
Here you going, David?
Oh.
Bye, David.
Bye, David.
Guys, I made it back.
Back at JU.
My goodness. Almost done this week.
Yeah.
We're good.
Didn't we all?
Bye.
Bye, vlog.